Everyone, welcome to the New York Aquarium! Thank you and hello everyone! My name is Michelle and it is my pleasure to introduce our stars of the show today! Please give a warm welcome to Pickles, his trainer Stephanie, and Marco and his trainer Sarah! Wild, sea lions can be found all along our west coast, as far north as Canada, and as far south as Mexico. Sea lions are very social animals, and they gather in large groups called rookeries. Now, these rookeries can be pretty noisy places. Males vocalize to announce and defend their territory, while females vocalize to identify their pups on a crowded beach. Sea lions can also communicate with each other through a breath exchange, which just so happens to look a whole lot like a sea lion kiss. Sea lions are part of a large group of mammals called pinnipeds. This includes seals, like our harbor seal Pickle, so you can see center stage. Sea lions, just like Marco. And walruses. Now, I bet everyone here knows what a walrus looks like, right? But it can be a bit trickier to tell the difference between a seal and a sea lion. So here are a few hints on how to do just that. First, take a look at the side of the animal's head. If you see ear flaps, you are looking at a sea lion. Seals do not have those. Seals have very short front flippers, while the sea lions are long and flexible. They use their front flippers to pull themselves through the water, just like we do. And their back flippers are used for steering. Sea lions can also rotate their hips totally underneath their bodies, making them extremely mobile on land. But don't just take my word for it. Hit it! But just in case any of you here were wondering, yes, our jobs really are as awesome as they seem. We are absolutely honored to work with these magnificent animals that you see here. And we're even more thrilled to share that connection with every single one of you. Here at the Aqua Theater, over at Sea Cliffs, Conservation Hall, Ocean Wonder Sharks, Spineless, the Playquarium, and now Sea Change, we work every day to bring you closer to the wonders in your own backyard, because we believe that anyone that visits a zoo or an aquarium and meets wonderful animals just like Pickles and Marco, well then they too will be inspired to protect wildlife. At the Wildlife Conservation Society, we stand as a window to nature. We stand for wildlife, and we invite all of you to stand with us. Now let me please introduce our next sea lion star. This is 8-year-old Clark. So fish and fun are very easy to come by here at the aquarium. But it's an entirely different story out in the wild. Sea lions have to go and catch their fish. All the while, something is just waiting to catch them. Lurking beneath the water, stalking their quarry, just waiting for the perfect moment to strike. You know it, a sea lion's primary predator, the great white shark! Very funny, you two. There's no sharks here at the Aqua Theater. It's true, sharks and killer whales do prey on California sea lions, but there is a bigger danger out in that ocean, and it's not another predator. It's plastic. That's right, the plastic that we all use every day ends up in our oceans, where it traps and kills millions of marine mammals, fish, turtles, seabirds. I'm talking huge amounts of plastic. Stephanie, what is that? A plastic bottle, and Clark just found this in the pool. Oh my goodness, this is so embarrassing. Please don't pay attention to any of this. I'm just gonna go ahead and throw this out in the trash. What's up? Oh, that is right. Plastic must never go in the trash. Plastic belongs in the recycling. Nice job, buddy. So, where was I? I was talking about plastic. Hey, wait a second. I checked this pool not even 5 minutes before the show, and it was spotless. I mean, how could a plastic bottle have just gotten in there? Unless someone put it in there, Stephanie. Well, if it wasn't you, then who could it have been? Clark? Oh my goodness. Did you put that plastic bottle in there? All right. I think he was just trying to make a point. And you know what? He's right. This is serious. Plastic is choking our oceans. Did you know that humans use over 50 billion plastic bottles a year, and only 1 in 5 will be recycled? Just 1 in 5. I know, buddy. It's shocking. But consider this. If Stephanie and I, and all of you here today, switch to a reusable bottle instead of a single-use plastic one, well, that will add up to a ton of plastic saved from our oceans and help countless marine mammals, just like Clark. It is truly amazing how the small changes that we all make add up to an enormous impact. And here at the New York Aquarium, that is something to celebrate. Hit it.
Yeah.
Now, in just a moment, this will be bringing Townsend's portion of the show to an end.